The History of Apple. Apple Computer was established in 1976 by the former school friends Steve Wozniak and Steve Jobs. The company's first product was the Apple I, a $500 computer on a single circuit board. Identifying an opportunity to differentiate their product, Jobs packaged the Apple II, like other consumer goods of the time, helping it to fit comfortably in contemporary homes. Despite this, sales of the Apple II only exploded when VisiCalc reached the market. Sales in 1979 reached $55 million, growing to $117 million by 1980. Unfortunately for the company, the Apple III, Lisa and Macintosh did not enjoy their predecessor's popularity and fell woefully short of their sales targets. This run of bad luck came to an end when Apple acquired shares in Adobe. By packaging Adobe's PostScript software with their LaserWriter, Apple created the concept of desktop publishing, offering its users functionality which could not be accessed using an IBM PC. The following years were a great success for the company, which launched the PowerBook and the company's advanced new operating system, System 7. After 1993, Apple's sales fell again, and it was only with the launch of the iMac that the company returned to profitability. Since the iMac's launch, Apple has gone from strength to strength, launching numerous successful hardware and software products including the MacBook, iPod, and iPhone, iTunes, and GarageBand. Main markets, products and competitors. Apple currently operates in three markets: consumer electronics, personal computers, and mobile communications. Apple maintains its heritage as a PC manufacturer with the Mac range of PCs and laptops. Apple also develops its own operating systems for its computers. Apple's main product in the consumer electronics market is the iPod range with the compatible iTunes software. The iPhone is Apple's recent entry into the mobile communications market, a product completely new to the company. Apple's major competition for the core of the business is Microsoft Windows, challenging the Mac operating system. Apple survives by providing better innovation and integration between other successful Apple products.
PC, what are you... Listen, friend, it's not very safe for me right now, you understand? There's a lot of spyware out there. It sneaks into your system, follows you wherever you may go. In fact, take these.
No.
They'll keep you safe.
PC, honestly, I don't need them. Really, I'm good. I run Mac OS X, so I don't have to worry about your spyware and viruses. You take them.
Yeah, you're right. I probably should have a backup anyway.
Yeah.
You never saw me. Never saw who? Me, PC. Oh! Ah!
Core technologies. Apple's core technologies have developed from its origins within the personal computer industry in the 1970s. More specifically, to create whole products, software optimized for the hardware, and an incredibly attractive brand image. Apple exploited the existing resources that lied within the company to develop the iPod MP3 media device in 2001. It used a relatively standard 2.5-inch hard drive and a very user-friendly interface, two of the key strengths of Apple. The iPod's usability with iTunes has also been key to its dominance of the personal media device market. Another example of Apple's integrating capabilities is through the iPhone and its use of touchscreen interface. Apple have basically improved an old technology and created a product that is far superior than any of its rivals.
Shocking, but we're nothing, we're just moments. We're clever, but we're clueless, we're just human.
Innovative activities. A company that only researches will struggle to make a profit. A company that purely innovates will eventually run out of fresh material to market. R&D spending. Apple is incredibly effective in organizing its R&D spending. In fact, it has recently been listed as the 7th best R&D company in the world by R&D Magazine. Apple has maximized the value of its R&D spending. That is, it demonstrates strong NPD, new product development, performance. As a mechanistic organization, Apple carries out predominantly experimental development or incremental innovation. Apple's management of R&D is critical to its success, with a move to a more decentralized model in recent years. This provides involvement and collaboration with manufacturers and suppliers, the knowledge transfer allowing Apple to focus primarily on the design and marketing of its products. Innovative strategy. Apple started life as a fast follower, delivering low-cost computers. This was possible because of Steve Wozniak's process innovations, which allowed the Apple I to be manufactured with fewer components than its competitors. Since then, the company has positioned itself as an offensive innovator, introducing radical innovations to the market. Under Apple's value engineering strategy, new technologies are restricted to expensive products until production costs can be reduced through economies of scale. Apple adopts an open innovation model, drawing on external sources of innovation to complement its internal developments. Having identified an innovative solution, the company guards its intellectual property fiercely, and patents are filed for all designs, even those which don't make it to market. Challenges and opportunities. The key challenges and opportunities for Apple can be divided into three areas: hardware, software, and company policy. The brand relies on compatibility between its products, which becomes more challenging as ranges expand. Opportunities are afforded by the transfer of technology from top-end products to the next generation of lower-cost models. Examples include the use of accelerometer technology developed for the iPod Touch to enhance the latest iPod Nano. Apple must ensure that the latest version of macOS, its proprietary operating system, continues to offer benefits over Microsoft's Windows. The choice of Apple's next CEO will have a significant impact on the company's innovative activities and represents a key opportunity to define a roadmap for future innovation.